vaccine that can help prevent cancer. If that sounds ridiculous, let me tell you all about the HPV vaccine. You may probably have heard of it, maybe on my own YouTube channel or my Instagram or my book or my podcast. I do a little bit too much. But if you haven't heard of it, don't worry, you're in the right place, because today we're talking all about the HPV vaccine or the cervical cancer vaccine, and we're going to be answering your biggest questions about the HPV vaccine. Woohoo! What the hell is HPV? That's a very understandable question if you have that. So HPV is a group of viruses. It's a big family. So it's the human papilloma virus family. And there's lots and lots of different types of viruses in it. So we have different strains. To understand this, think of it like this. That remember when we had COVID, there were different strains of COVID that were coming out. We had Delta and we had Omicron and, you know, we had Acha Pacha. So the same way, HPV also has lots and lots of different types of strains. There's like close to 200 strains. So it's a very big family. Of viruses, very happy lovey family. But there are some strains that are more strongly associated with causing certain cancers. There's also cancers of the mouth, the back of the throat, which is called the oropharynx, if you want to be really sciencey and nerdy about it. Or we have cancers of the anus, cancers of the penis, of the vulva, of the vagina. You know, HPV is very strongly linked with lots of different cancers. But the one that I'm going to be focusing on a lot today is cancer of the cervix. Uterus bhaiya ki jai to hai ye hamare channel pe. So let's understand what the cervix is first before we go further. Obviously this is an extremely cute uterus, but our uterus actually doesn't really look like this. It looks a little bit more like this, and don't get worried, because this is supposed to be a diseased uterus, so it's showing different kinds of diseases that can happen in the uterus. This is not what a normal uterus looks like. This part is the vagina. This is where the penis goes in, this is where sex toys goes in, this is where your menstrual cup or your tampons will go in. This part is the uterus. This is where the baby lives, you know, when you're pregnant. This part is also where the period blood comes from. It exits the body and it exits out through the vagina. And the bottom part of this uterus, this part here, that is called the cervix. So cervix literally means neck. And it's a very, very common site for cancer. Like, it's so common, in fact, that in India, cervical cancer, cancer of that part of the uterus, the cervix, is the second most common cancer in urban women and the most common cancer in rural women. So, you know, we get a lot of cervical cancer. It's no joke. So if this is the human body, this part right here is your cervix. Haath hatalo bhai. Inside this pelvis sits a lot of, there sit a lot of organs, and one of the organs that does sit here is the uterus. Why I'm so passionate about talking about this is because cervical cancer is often diagnosed very, very late. The symptoms are extremely vague. There are things like constipation and, you know, feeling heavy in your abdomen or just feeling not pleasant. If you're feeling constipated and not pleasant, you won't think, "Arey, mujhe cancer ho gaya, or I have cancer in my cervix." So most often people don't go to the doctor in time and don't get diagnosed in time, which means that India, our country, has the highest number of deaths from cervical cancer in the whole world. This is a very shameful statistic and we need to fix it. Sabse aage honge Hindustani, par cervical cancer mein nahi hona hai hum sabse aage. We gotta fix this, and one of the best ways of fixing this problem is to get the HPV vaccine. Now, coming back to the vaccine angle of things, HPV is linked with more than 90% of all cervical cancers and very strongly related with lots of different cancers as well. As long as you get the HPV vaccine, you're protecting yourself from lots of variety of different cancers that are caused by HPV, by the human papilloma virus. So how does this work? What is cancer? Let's start there actually. Basically what happens in cancer is that our cells, just like humans, you know, we don't live infinitely. Aging happens and you start dying. After a certain point, our body is like, "Ab bahut ho gaya," you know, like, "I'm done." What happens in cancer is that your cell is like, "Hum to nahi marenge sanam." You know, there's some changes in the DNA of your cell, and these cells, they start growing uncontrollably. When they grow uncontrollably, we get a tumor. And this essentially is one of the ways cancer happens. This is one of the forms of cancer. And the same thing happens with cervical cancer. You get these undying cells, that these zombie cells essentially, that refuse to die, and they make a mass. Certain strains of HPV, particularly strain 16 and strain 18, are very strongly linked with causing cancer of the cervix. Other strains cause other cancers, like I've mentioned before, but these two strains are the ones we really freak out a lot about, because remember, cervical cancer is often not diagnosed in time and people get it diagnosed very, very late, by the time there's not enough time to save them. Now, there's three main kinds of vaccines, actually four main kinds of vaccines that are available. The first is called Cervarix. This vaccine that I got when I was 13 years of age protects you from the two main cancer-causing strains, 16 and 18. Then you can get Gardasil 4. This protects you from 16 and 18 plus two other high-risk strains. And then there is Gardasil 9, which protects you from the two main cancer-causing strains plus seven other strains. And lastly, you've got Cervavac. I'll get to Cervavac in just 1 second. So you've got these vaccines that are available. They are quite expensive. When I got the Gardasil vaccine, it was 2,000 rupees per dose. Gardasil 4 comes for around 3,500 rupees per dose. Gardasil 9 comes for about 9,500 rupees per dose. So this is not a cheap vaccine, but it really does protect you from cancer. And obviously, as we've been talking that, you know, it's a very expensive vaccine, there are movements to make this vaccine cheaper. So the Serum Institute of India did announce that by December of 2022, they will be launching the Indian cervical cancer vaccine, which will be cheaper. I don't know what the stage is right now, but it hasn't come into the market as of August 2023. It should come out sometime soon. We will find out, and hopefully it will be cheaper and more people will be able to afford it, because this is a life-saving vaccine. It's genuinely really important. Now that you know what are the different types of vaccines available, let's talk about how you get it. Find a private doctor, find a private gynecologist or a pediatrician and go and get the vaccine. You will get it either in 3 doses or 2 doses. It depends on your age. So anyone between 9 years of age to 45 years of age, this is the spectrum. Man, woman, whatever your gender is, you can get this vaccine as long as you're over 9 years of age and you're under 45 years of age. Now, how many vaccines you get depends on when you get it. So if you're between 9 to 15 years of age, you will only get 2 shots. If you are 15 to 45 years of age, you will get 3 shots. Your doctor will guide you, but you will get first dose and you'll get 1 month later and you'll get 6 months later. So 0, 1, 6 is the protocol we follow for this vaccine. Now, here's the biggest question that comes up when I talk about the age groups that can get the vaccine. So a lot of people who Google search this vaccine find out that people over the age of 26 shouldn't get this vaccine. So that is old data. Up until 2018, we did believe that up to 26 is when you should get the vaccine. But after 2018, we had lots of studies, we had lots of, you know, new guidelines that said people up to the age of 45 can get this vaccine. You don't have to be under 26 to get this vaccine. You have to be under 45 to get this vaccine. If you see that you're living in a country that is not India, your doctor may advise you that you can skip this vaccine. So I'm going to answer why that is in the next question. So the second biggest question that comes up when people think about this vaccine is, I've already had sex. Will this vaccine protect me? There's a huge common misconception that if you've had sex, you know, this vaccine is useless. That's not true. So HPV, the human papilloma virus, is a sexually transmitted infection. It does get in your body as an STI and it leads to changes that may lead to cancer in the future. But just because you've had sex does not mean that you have been exposed to the high-risk strains, the strains that are strongly associated with causing cancer. You may have been exposed to them, but not necessarily. So that's why it's super important that even if you've had sex, even if you've had a few partners, please get the vaccine. It will still, there's a good chance that it will protect you. With all of that said, of course, the vaccine is best taken when you are young and when you had no sexual exposure. So ideal age group is 9 to 15 years of age. Please get it then. Now, coming to the second part of this question, which I left behind in the last part. A lot of Western countries, for example, the US and France and Germany, they often, you know, if you go to the doctor and you say you want this vaccine, they often say you don't need it. That's because the average age of sexual exposure, according to public health data in these countries, is a little bit lower. I can guarantee you that in India, it's also as low. The public health data suggests that you may already be exposed to those strains by that point, but I insist, I still believe you should get the vaccine, because there is a high likelihood that out of those 200 strains, you may not be exposed to the 2 strains that cause cancer. So get it. If it's affordable for you, please get it. There's another test that your doctor might suggest before you get the vaccine. If your doctor is not suggesting it, I suggest that you do it anyway, and you should also do this test every couple of years anyway, every 3 years ideally. So this is called a pap smear. So what the doctor can do in this pap smear test, they can couple it with an HPV test to see that if you already have HPV. Again, if they do this test, they will find out if you're infected with the higher risk strain. So even if you're HPV positive, does not mean that the vaccine is useless, unless you're infected with 16 and 18, in which case you don't need to get the vaccine because you're already infected with the strains that are known for causing cancer. Oh, important addition here. Just because you're infected with 16 and 18 does not mean that you will 100% have cancer. If you're diagnosed with being infected with these strains, your doctor will give you options on what all they can do to make sure that you don't get this cancer. That's why it's so important to get the pap smear, because they can diagnose pre-cancerous changes. So changes that happen in your cells that occur even before cancer has started developing. So what happens in a pap smear? So if this is your vulva, this is, you know, the parts between your legs. So we take a soft brush like this, just like the same brush that you use to do this. It's a soft brush exactly like this. We insert this into the vulva and we get some cells from your cervix. This is how it looks like IRL. How it looks like internally is, this is your uterus. We would go in into your vagina and we would get some cells from your cervix. We would just brush them. Andar nahi dalte hain, don't worry. Yeah, we'll get some cells from your cervix like this. We will put these cells under a slide and then study them under a microscope to see if there are any changes that might be either precancerous and also to see if your cells are already infected with HPV, you know, and find out what strain it is. If your doctor hasn't advised a pap smear test, please get it anyway. And once you start getting one, you should get one ideally every 3 years. It's very important for your overall well-being and your sexual health and your reproductive health to make sure that this one simple jhadu lagane wala test inside your cervix can protect you and prevent cancer from developing. So it's a simple thing, please karwalo yaar. And yeah, that's it. This is the grand HPV video that answers all of your questions. Now, I hope this video has been helpful for you and you've learned something, but I have a request to make to you myself. I think you can tell that I'm very, very passionate about this subject. I have a petition to the government. This vaccine is extremely expensive and we have seen in countries like the UK. In the UK, the cervical cancer vaccine or the HPV vaccine is a part of the national immunization protocol. What this means is that everybody mandatorily gets this vaccine. So they give it in school-going age. So when school-going children of ages 9 to 13 were given this and everybody got this vaccine, they saw that over a 10-year period, UK had a 90% reduction in cervical cancer cases. We don't see numbers like that in medicine. This is a miraculous number, 90% reduction. It's a really, really extensively useful vaccine. So remember, India has the highest burden of deaths from cervical cancer compared to any other country in the world. So we really need to act now and we need to act fast. So we have a petition to the government. I've been working with the Har Adhikar Foundation and change.org to petition the government and essentially say vinti kar rahe hain ki please include the HPV vaccine in the national immunization protocol. What this will do is that it will make it mandatory for everybody to get this vaccine, and of course this will mean that the vaccine will become affordable, so everybody in this country will be able to get the vaccine, which will be a huge thing. I really dream of that day. So I'm linking my petition in the description box below. It would be hugely helpful if you could sign that petition and share it with your friends so more and more people are able to access this vaccine and are able to get vaccinated and are able to protect themselves from cervical and other HPV related cancers. Bless kar do, bless, bless, personal favor, bless. That's it guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope some of your questions were answered. If you still have more questions, I am happy to make yet another video about HPV and HPV vaccines and cervical cancer. So let me know. If you did like this video, please consider subscribing, please consider liking this video, sharing this video, subscribing, hitting the bell icon, all of that. I don't even know what all of this is, but kar lo yaar, acha rahega na. Kyotras love, kyotras love. Okay, that's it for now. Bye.